sick was that intro. Honestly, nearly as sick as my voice sounds, even though I'm not ill. Like, I just don't get it. So, Groovy Girlies, welcome back to the channel. I know I have been so MIA at the minute. Is that correct? MIA? Missing in action? That is correct. However, I'm going to be completely honest with you. I've kind of just had a break. Being on holiday for literally a whole ass month, even though I have been uploading, you really wouldn't have recognised the fact that I've been away because I've still kept pretty constant. The last week, however, I didn't upload because I was actually at a festival called Benicassim where I got robbed and my friends got robbed on two different occasions. Kind of just been a bit preoccupied. So I haven't had a chance to film or edit any videos this week, so I am really sorry about that. But hopefully this announcement video will completely throw your mind off the fact that I didn't upload for a week, because this is major, 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 major news. Like, literally made my whole entire life, my whole entire year. I just can't believe it's officially launch day, and I can't wait to tell you guys all about it. So in this video, I'm going to be going through the whole journey of Notice, like how it even started, how it came about, who it's run by. I'm going to answer your questions and also show you the launch, show you the website and everything like that. And then after this video, you can actually go shop the range. So I am so, so freaking excited. Let's just get straight on into it. So me and 10 of us so far, there will be more in the future. And this brand is called Get Notice, and I'm literally so gassed. It's actually run by my management. That is kind of how I'm involved in this whole thing. They reached out to me and asked if I wanted to launch a collection with them, as well as many of my friends on the management as well. And there's so many more to come. We've got like Hannah and Tasha. As you can see on the website, their names are listed below. So their launches are coming soon, and I'm so gassed for you to see them because I've seen some of their pieces and they're so freaking cute. So this brand is technically an influencer-led brand, which is what it says on the website. But as you guys know, I hate the word influencer. I hate the word fans. I hate all of that in between. I just think we're people. So I guess think of it as a fashion brand that is created by my management and the people you love and watch. I assume that is the best I can explain it without sounding very egotistical. So you probably heard me mention the fact that it's eco-friendly, ethical, and sustainable. And that is literally the thing I love most about this brand. We basically went and visited the factories in Portugal. We got to meet the team behind the scenes. We got to see actual clothes being produced. There's so many familiar brands that are made in this exact same factory, and I can promise you the quality is so insane. I'm not really too sure how to pronounce the name of the brand. You guys know and love it. It's Moschino. Some of you say Moschino. I doubt it's Moschino. I think it's Moschino. Let's just clarify that. I go to a fashion school, for God's sake, and I don't even know how to pronounce the name. But that is made in the factory, and I think it's so, so cool that something I've been working on is made in a factory alongside such a big brand, like a brand that so many people love. Also, the fact that I'm even involved in this whole thing blows my mind. Like, I'm a part of a fashion brand. People can buy clothes that I have designed. And I did it with my best friend. I'm literally just so happy right now. I just can't even deal. As I was saying before I carried on rambling on, the clothes are sustainable, and also the tags that are attached to the clothes are biodegradable. I actually have an example to show you right now. This is how it would come arriving at your door. So these are my shorts that are going to be launching today. This size doesn't actually fit me, so I will do a whole haul of everything from my collection once I receive it. That will probably be going up in like a week or so. And as I get further into this video, you will realize that I do have more coming out. So if you don't like the look of anything on the website so far, which fingers crossed I hope you do, then there will be more coming, so don't worry, I'll get into that later. But it comes in a plastic bag like this, and I know what you're thinking, plastic bag, but it's sustainable and everything's supposed to be eco-friendly. So that's why it says this on the bag. It says made from 100% recycled plastic, please pay it forward and recycle this bag again. Such a nice touch at the fact that literally everything in this brand is eco-friendly, sustainable. And let me just show you the tags. I think this is so, so cute. So inside it says Notice by Haz. There's my signature. That is so freaking cool. So this tag, actually, if you plant it in the ground, it will grow a flower because it has seeds within it, and I think that is so cool. As I said, biodegradable, and I just love the fact that this brand is working towards making the earth a greener place. Like, that really is something that resonates with me so well. And it says this tag was clothing and now will become a flower. I literally love that so much. Also, when we went to the factories, which I will get to in a minute, I will show you the whole showreel of that. They gave us a little gift which was so adorable, and it came in this bag. It says this bag will be a flower, but this bag was clothing. I just love it. I literally love it. Little details like this make me so much more intrigued about a brand. It makes me really want to invest in it. Hopefully you guys feel the same. Like, I love the fact that fashion brands are now trying to be more sustainable, and this brand is definitely trying its very best, and I just love it so much. So before we dig straight into the clothing, I'm going to check in every single bit of footage that I have from the very start in January, when this clothing range was even thought of, all the way to now. So yeah, let's just see the footage.
Very much.
Sorry. Let's not get the bag in, yeah?
Hey.
finding out.
I'm really enjoying it. Basically what we've done so far is plan, say around 9 specific, all ranging from like jumpers, joggers, t-shirts.
Fashion designer.
I want them now, like I want them now.
They'll be out, when people are watching this, it'll be out.
Oh my god, that would be so happy.
I got a call, my sample designs are in. Everything in my size is ready as a sample and I'm so, so, so excited to see them. I wanna see if it lived up to my expectations. I know there's a few tweaks that we've gotta do just because I saw the CAD designs and there was like a few minor changes, but apart from that, I loved it so much. So yeah, oh my God, I can't believe I actually get to try on what I've worked towards and what I've made like myself. It's just gonna be so crazy. I'm so excited. Oh my God, let's just go, let's just go. Kitty Winks.
I actually can't believe.
Mine looks like a porno. I've had no sleep at all. Didn't sleep on the plane. I haven't ate since 2.
Coming soon.
Coming soon, bitches. I love the fact that you can click on the names and it takes you to the Instagram.
Me too, it turns me on. That's how you could do that. That's how you could do that.
Oh, I just said the exact opposite of what you just said.
What did you say?
Oh, look how pretty she looks.
Oh,
and you were there. Awful. So the background probably looks a little bit different compared to, you know, where I live. And that's because we're actually in Alicante. We're in Calpe for the shooting of Noticed, which I'm sure you're all aware of by now because we have been promoting it on our social medias. I really haven't updated you guys at all this whole trip because I was dying from sleep deprivation and hay fever on the way here. So the location is kind of like a pink hotel. It's pink walls, it's like a rooftop.
There's blue walls as well.
And blue walls.
And a pool.
Because we're gonna go shoot our clothing.
Oh, so God,
and we're getting into the taxi. Oh, I'm really blue as well. That's always good. Hi, Dan. If you want me to take over, just give me the location. Oh my God, I can't believe we're doing
this. I can't believe.
You can't believe.
We were just saying that like 2 years ago, we never would have believed that we were doing this together.
No, we wouldn't, because Anna hated my ass. Mental. I'm excited to try everyone else's designs. Yeah, I'm excited to try my own, but like I haven't seen anyone else's, haven't even seen Anna's.
Yeah, I haven't seen yours.
So I'm excited to see what everyone else's design is. Very intriguing. Girlies, we have kind of nearly finished for shooting for today. We've done so many still images. I know we've got videography tomorrow, which I'm really excited for because I feel like I look better on videos than I do in photos, so it's all Gucci. Me, Hope, Jordan and Anna are all gonna do some joint ones together, which I'm really, really, really excited for because I just like bounce off other people whenever I'm shooting. I feel like it's so much more comfortable than when you're doing it by yourself. Everyone's looking beautiful, beautiful.
Off duty. Oh my God, Inception.
How insane insane was that journey. Honestly, I am so lucky. And I don't mean that in a big-headed way. Like, I literally am just so lucky to even be a part of this brand, have my ideas listened to, be a part of something with a team that I absolutely adore, and also do it alongside my best friends. So far, I have 10 items, but don't stress, there is gonna be more. I am having 3 more released in a few days, and those 3 are actually some of my favorite items. So I'm so excited for you guys to see them. Sadly, as I said earlier, I don't have any of the items with me to haul them, but that's gonna be a completely separate video along with sizes and everything like that, just so you guys can get a gist of what you're actually buying into. If you do have any questions at all, there is a frequently asked questions tab on the website that will answer all of your questions, just so you don't have to comment them below and wait for a reply from me. I will be going through all the comments on this video though, of course, as per usual. I love talking with you guys, and especially at a time like this when you need answers for things. So yeah, the link for the notice site will be in the description. Hopefully that answers some of your questions, but if not, do drop them down below. So firstly, this is my favorite item. It's a part of a duo in this collection, and it is the orange ribbed crop top. Honestly, I've never loved something more in my life. I can't wait to own this myself and wear it out. You guys have absolutely been loving the photos of me in this as well, so thank you so much for the support on that. I can't wait to see you all rock it as well. Summer in the City is approaching, maybe you can wear it to that. If I see anyone at Sitsi with these items on, I think I'm gonna cry. Like, me seeing that in person, something I've designed, that's gonna be so weird, but like so surreal. So this particular item is £15. That's something very similar to what I'd pay for a crop top personally, and I love it so much. It's so comfortable. It just sits right on my chest. I know I haven't got any titties, but it really just does me justice. And orange to me is just a happiness color. Makes me think of good times. The logo on there as well, 2899, is also very sentimental to me, I guess, because I'm a Leo and I'm very big-headed. It's my birthday and birth year. So as I'm uploading this, literally is 3 days away from my birthday. My birthday is the 28th of July, 1999. So 2899. So that is the reasoning behind that. It appears on a lot of my clothing in this range. I just wanted something that was a bit more sentimental to me, so that if I do see someone wearing it, it's got a bit of me on it, you know? So to match, we have the drawstring joggers with the piping down the side. These are £28, which I think is so affordable for a pair of good joggers. When I tell you they are so soft, the material is so thick, the cuffs at the bottom, I wanted them to be longer. That's just how I prefer wearing my joggers. It's adjustable because of the drawstring. I love the piping. I loved the design process of this. When we sat down and made this in Portugal, I had a vision exactly of what I wanted, and they did this to a T. This cohort was everything and more I could have asked for. Next is the scoop neck bodysuit with my little 2899 logo on again. This is £20, which for a good bodysuit, I don't think is that bad. I also didn't want like spaghetti straps. I wanted it to be quite sturdy straps. It's kind of ribbed. It's like a vest material. The only thing about this bodysuit was it was supposed to just have the 2899 with like a circle around it. I don't really know where the blue came from, but I'm really not hating it. I actually really like the color blue, so it kind of works for me. But during the design process, when we first did this, it didn't have that on. And then later, when I came to look at the clothes, when we went for meetings and stuff, it had it on, and I genuinely liked it, so I kept it. But I just thought I'd throw that out there to, you know, show you the design process and how things can easily change. So this is the oversized sweat in black. I absolutely love the detail of the orange and the pink around the neck. I also love the fact that it's got a zip. I basically wanted something like this because myself and Freya actually wear so many items like this, but I didn't have one that I really loved. And me personally, I definitely get this in oversized. I'm normally an extra small. However, I prefer this to be oversized, so I'd probably get it in like a 12, just so I want it to come just above my knees. So if any of you are looking for an oversized jumper, then this would definitely be the one for you. And personally, I think Eliza pulls this off so well. Eliza is one of my very good friends and one of my managers, so yeah, we love her. She looks incredible in it. So then we have the oversized tees with my 2899 logo on it. You can either get this in white or black, and I just love them so much. I wore this the whole time during Spain. This is definitely one of my favorite pieces. I have a lot of favorite pieces, I've noticed that. Personally, I think it's really nice because you could either have it really small and not really wear it as a crop top, but a small top, if you know what I mean. Or you could have it oversized and wear it as a t-shirt dress. Honestly, it is endless. Took it into your jeans, took it into your shorts, the list is endless. So now it comes to the time where I talk about the items being released on the 1st of August. So 2 of these are my absolute faves. I want them to be released earlier because I love them so much. I hope you guys do too. They really give me like a tennis vibe. Really strange, but I think the outfit is so cute. So firstly, we have the high neck long sleeve zip crop top, and I just love the color. I love everything about it. I love how it sits on the model. I've personally tried all of these items on and it fits me so well. It really reminds me of the neon green crop that I have that I'm wearing in this photo. This is definitely where I got the inspiration from for this. And this retails for £28, which I would normally pay at probably Urban Outfitters or something like that. It's a little bit more pricey than what I did expect it to be. However, I understand that we have to cover costs with things, and it is a really good material, guys. It really is, and it's so comfortable. Personally, if I thought it was completely out of your price range and just completely ridiculous to even buy, then I would pull it from the site. I really would. There'd be no way in hell that I would sell it to you guys. So this is the priciest thing in my range, and I do love it so much. Me personally, I would spend the money on this, and it isn't that much more expensive than the other items. It is the priciest one, hence why I've left it till last, but hopefully you like it. So this is the mini skirt with the piping up the side. It really reminds me of Greece, you know, the pink ladies. I feel like this is something that they would wear, and I'm so inspired by that era of time. It also cinches your waist in so much, and I'm not gonna lie, it kind of gives you an ass, and I really liked that because, you know, skinny mini girls, we gotta work with what we got, and it just gave me the loveliest figure. It doesn't actually have elastic around the waistband, which I prefer, and that's why it has the zip on the side, so it is very easy to get on because the zip goes all the way down. It goes so far. So the last things are the shorts that I actually have here, and I want to like talk to you about the shorts because they didn't really turn out how I expected them to, but I really do still like them, and I know there's going to be people out there that do like them too. I just have a very different taste to what they turned out to be, so we're going to talk through them. So these shorts retail for £30. Again, it is also the most expensive one. I have asked for them to be lowered just because I don't like them as much, so I don't really know what it says on the website right now. I will have to wait till launch day. Hopefully they've been lowered. But basically, during the design process, I said that I wanted like cargo pants, paper bag shorts, if that makes sense. If not the cargo pants, then definitely the paper bag, which, as you can see, the paper bag has been followed through with the idea. They are paper bag. And I wanted the material to be quite thick so that when you put them on, they don't just droop. They kind of go out like a paper bag would. I think this just got lost in the design process because when we went to our first meeting, which I showed you, they weren't the material that I wanted them to be at all. And I also can't remember saying them I wanted in pink. But I get the fact that people pitch in their ideas, and ideas do get changed. I completely get that. I did also say I wanted the cross stitching, which it does have in it, so I'm very, very happy that that idea still stayed. The only problem with me personally for this item is the material. The way that my body is, as I said previously, I like to work with what I've got, and if something can emphasize what I've got, amazing. Literally, I love that so much. I love items that are like figure hugging, that show off my figure. That's just a bit of me. That's just what I prefer my clothes to be like. And some people don't like that. Some people prefer baggier items. Some people prefer items that just drop off them. It literally is just personal preference. But after seeing it around 2-3 times, I don't think it was actually possible for the material to be changed. I don't think there was a thicker material in the factory. So that's why the shorts are a thinner material, and that's why they don't actually stick out as much. I still personally think they look incredible on the model, and I know they're gonna look so sick on you guys as well. It's just personally not how I wanted it to turn out, which is completely fine because I know this is the fashion industry. You don't always get what you want, and I'm so happy with all my other items. I'm so happy I even got this opportunity, so I'm not gonna be like bitter or upset or anything like that. It's still such an amazing opportunity. I still got to produce clothes. I wouldn't change any of it for the world because it's just such an incredible opportunity. As I keep saying, I just can't. I'm literally mind blown. I did also want the crotch area to be a bit shorter so that they weren't so high-waisted, but again, if that's your cup of tea, bellissimo, lovely. So now I guess I'm just gonna answer your questions because a lot of you have been so confused about this. None of you even knew until a few weeks ago that Notice was even a fashion brand. Like, been so secret, guys. I really couldn't tell you, and I've been wanting to tell you for so long, and now it's out and we can discuss it, and I can answer all your questions that you've ever wanted to know. So the first question is, why is the name Get Noticed, and why did you choose it? I actually didn't choose it. My management chose this name, and I think they wanted it because they wanted us to make clothes that are personal to us, like our personal preference, our personal style, kind of what makes us stand out as being me or Anna or Sophie or Steph, just things that are our personal style. I think each person has a different meaning for this name, but that's what it is personally to me. Favorite thing about Get Noticed is definitely the fact that I could do it with my best friends, and also just I'm surrounded by such a good team. I've been able to travel to Portugal. I've never been there before. I was able to go to Calpe, which is such a beautiful destination. I was on a photo shoot. I met an amazing photographer and videographer. The whole team was just incredible, and I can't thank them enough for the work that they did for us out there. I got to put my ideas onto a bit of paper, and even though it was like, God, 7 months ago when I started planning all of this, and my fashion has changed, I still love all the items. Fashion obviously changes so frequently, and we all change our ideas of what we like quite literally every day, but during that time that was my style, and I love it. What are the price ranges? So roughly from what I've discussed in this video, you can probably tell it's ranging in between Pretty Little Thing prices and Misguided prices. However, the quality is like Urban Outfitters or something even more than that. The quality is so good, and the pricing is definitely lower than what it should be for the quality. As I said, for some of my items, I do wish they were a bit lower, and I have asked that. So yeah, that's why the prices are like they are, but I still think they're very affordable and I still think they are so good for the quality that you're receiving. Is designing clothes something you've always wanted to do? I go to a fashion university and yes, in a sense, I've always loved fashion. Not so much high-end fashion. I just personally love looking at people on the street and seeing what they're wearing and getting inspiration from that. I love changing my style up all the time. Honestly, if you saw me in January, I dress nothing how I do now. I don't do my makeup the same. I draw a triangle on my face just because of style. Like, no other reason. It just feels like it's me. Maybe if I was to have designed the clothes now, I would have included the triangle on some of the items. And I also have like more tattoos now. Maybe I would have included that on some of it. But I definitely say I have an interest in it, and obviously living with Byron and Freya. Freya's a stylist, Byron's a photographer. We all go to the same uni. I am so influenced by fashion. YouTube is so influenced by fashion. I do fashion related videos. It's always been something that has been in the line for me. Why are there so many different YouTubers involved? So Notice was made and thought up of from my management. Obviously my management have YouTubers on there, and they basically reached out to people that they thought would be interested in producing fashion. There are so many more people that are going to have launches. There are so many more people that are going to have launches within this range as well. It's not just as 11 people, there are more people, some that you won't expect and some that are familiar faces. That's all I can say. And I just love everything that everyone designed. Everyone came together, everyone did their own individual work and design process, and then seeing the end result was just so nice. So that is the reason why it's just YouTubers and Instagrammers, because it's a management that have created it who have YouTubers and Instagrammers on their management. I hope that answers that question. It was a bit weird, but yeah. What sizes do you go to? So I'm pretty sure it goes from a size 4 to 18, and they're looking on expanding that as well after the first drop. They just want to see how the first drop goes, I'm pretty sure. But if you do have any questions, the frequently asked question bar is on the website if you have like any inquiries. Also, if you want to message the Get Noticed page, they always reply. They always reply to comments and DMs. Me personally, I do want to see more plus sizes get introduced to the range. Obviously that will come over time. They want to see how the brand takes off, but I am so excited for more sizes to be introduced. I really am. Obviously being a part of the brand, I want this brand to be as inclusive as possible, and hopefully it will be. And I'm just so excited for it to get kickstarted and get on the road and for you guys to see it. So if you do now want to go shop Notice after I've been rambling on forever, then the link will be in my description. And yeah, if you do buy something, please let me know down below. Shoot me a DM of your purchase order. I'm so excited to see you guys use your creativity and show me outfits that you create with the items. Even if it's not from my range, like, shoot me a DM. I want to see you support my friends. Their collections are all incredible. We've got dresses, crop tops, flared trousers, pajamas, two pieces, everything, like everything you could literally imagine. So yeah, that is all the questions that I feel are relevant to this conversation, and I'm actually going to leave the video here. So thank you so much guys for quite literally everything. I am so thankful with every single aspect of my life right now, and I owe it all to you guys. You guys have put me in this position. You have gave me these opportunities, and I can't wait to see you all literally next week for Summer in the City. We just want to hang out with you guys, see you as much as possible over the weekend. We will be walking around both Saturday and Sunday. On Friday, we also have to collect our tickets, so I guess we'll see you there too. I love you all so much, and I will see you in the next one. Okay, it's rap packed to my pulse flat. We keep it real, no false rap. I got 4 cars and they all black. Got 4 bras and they all that. We call that ballin'. Doing this is my call.